In this video, we'll be seeing about the recently announced One Nation, One Ration. So the central government has recently proposed about setting up One Nation, One Ration by July 2020, thereby enabling portability of food security across the country well connected through a single network. Before getting into the One Nation, One Ration scheme, it is pertinent for us to know about the food security and the PDS schemes in India. The Food and Agriculture Organization defines food security as the situation where all people at all times have physical and economic access to the food which meets their dietary and nutrition needs. Food and Agriculture Organization defines food security as a status where all people get food at all times. The main crux of Food and Agriculture Organization definition on food security is availability of food for all people at all the time. The food is not only for their dietary need, it is also for the nutritional need of the every individual of the world. And it is also about ensuring the food security is also about providing both physical and economic access to the food. And now in India, the internal migration is on the rise. According to the economic survey 2017-18, every year the rural urban migration accounts for 10 crore Indian people. And with the increasing migration, the onus is on the government to provide subsidized grain in order to ensure the food security for the people who are already marginalized because of various other factors like drought and other natural disasters due to policy changes or due to lack of employment opportunity in their native place. And because of this, internal migration is happening. With this increasing internal migration, people are rooted out of their actual homes and partial migration is also happening. Whereas one member of the family is leaving the native place and going to some other part of the country. And the family members, they still remain in their native place. This internal migration situation has posed a question on India's food security. And this, the One Nation, One Ration has been touted as a solution to provide food security for the migrant community in India. The targeted public distribution system was started in 1997 to target the priority sector, that is the beneficiaries belonging to the below poverty line, to provide food grains to those people. The TPDS was started in 1997. But the TPDS was targeted, but it had more exclusion and inclusion error. And recently in 2018, the central government has instructed the state governments to end-to-end computerize the TPDS accounts. Almost all the states have completed the end-to-end computerization. Now, the central government has asked the state governments to link their PDS system, the TPDS system, to their integrated PDS management system, IPMS, thereby creating a single network of PDS system all over the country. This will enable portability of food security benefits. So for example, a migrant labor from Assam who is working as a wage labor in Tamil Nadu doesn't have any food security benefits in Tamil Nadu. With the meager income he is earning here, he has to send a part to the dependent family in his native place. Also at the same time, he has to take care of himself. And with the ardent physical labor being involved, it is necessary for him to have good food. Without good food, his health is getting affected. This pushes him into a vicious cycle, and this will create a huge impact on, it will create a multiplier effect when you consider all the migrant community living in different parts of the country. So far, 10 states have integrated their PDS system to the central network. And this is all about the basics and the necessity for creating portability in food security via One Nation, One Ration. And now, let's see the analysis. What will be the challenges that will be faced by the government while implementing this One Nation, One Ration? And so far, the first challenge is pertaining with the availability of data. Economic Survey 2018-19 has mentioned about the importance of data in taking important policy decisions. And this applies even to this One Nation, One Ration. So far, we don't have proper, exact, erudite data on mobility of Indian masses. So only after analyzing the data, we can come to know what kind of grain has to be supplied to which geographical location. This is first challenge. The second challenge is about the already existing food security laws in the states. Many states have domicile-based food security legislations. And now when we are going to move towards a centralized, regime of food security, distribution of food grains to people, it is necessary that the state governments have to make some amendments to the legislation. And this will take some time. And how this legal hurdle has to be crossed, it's a big question mark. It's a big challenge for the central government. And the third challenge is pertaining to the partial migration. We already discussed about partial migration. Let's take the example of the Assam migrant again. The sole breadwinner of the family is working in Tamil Nadu and their family is dependent on him in Assam. So both of them are needing food grains. With his income, he can buy grains here. And what will be the status of his family to acquire grains? So the food security of both the people are under question because of partial migration. there is no clarity from the government how they are going to answer this question posed by partial migration. Integrating this partial migration in government schemes is not a new thing to the central government. Earlier, in Rashtriya Swachha Bhima Yojana, the government has introduced the partial migration clause, wherewith both the migrant worker and his family in his native place both can avail the benefit of insurance. The same has to be introduced in the One Nation, One Ration card, so that both the migrant member and the family are not affected. Now let's see about the advantages of this One Nation, One Ration. Right to food is not deliberately a fundamental right, but the right to decent livelihood is a part of fundamental right given under Article 21. The right to dignity of human life is null and void without right to food. So right to food is also a part of Article 21. The lack of portability in food security benefits hampers the fundamental right of the migrant community. This portability factor in the One Nation, One Ration scheme will help people in gaining their food security. The second advantage is about the beneficiaries can choose their dealers from whom they are going to purchase their food grains. A recent study undertaken in the states of Bihar and Uttar Pradesh indicates that the subaltern masses, the common masses belonging to the marginal and vulnerable community, they are affected by the leakages happening at the level of dealers. It is not only the physical leakage, there is also some social exclusion. Based on the caste and based on religion, people are segregated from availing their food security benefits. So in the One Nation, One Ration, there has been an option given to the beneficiary. The beneficiary can go and select which dealer they are going to purchase the grains from. This is an advantage in the lines of social security also. These are the said advantages for this scheme. So what could be the possible disadvantages? Food is inalienable from the cultural aspect of every society. So when migrant people come here, what kind of food they are going to eat? A person from North India working in South India, whether there will be proper availability of wheat or proper availability of mustard oil. And in the same case, when someone from South India is moving into North India, whether there will be proper availability of dal and proper availability of rice. These are under question. So the government should ensure that the cultural aspects of food is also not lost through the process of this One Nation, One Ration. And this the second aspect is about the unequal social relations. The existing unequal social relation and the social dynamics happening in the country should not affect the marginalized people from getting their due food security. That is the second disadvantage. The third aspect is about the ideals of federalism that fuel the running of Indian democracy. The Schedule 7 of Indian Constitution is a linchpin of Indian federalism. PDS is a part of state list, and this One Nation, One Ration is being implemented by the central government. And this initiative, One Nation, One Ration, should not impinge the federal rights accorded on the state. In this video, we saw about the basics of food security and how the migrant community is increasing in the country and how according food security to the migrant community is a part of fundamental right, and how the One Nation, One Ration is going to address these problems, and what are the challenges that would possibly be faced by this One Nation, One Ration scheme, and also the advantages and disadvantages of the scheme. Government policies and the government schemes are always devised and designed in order to provide maximum benefit to the people. But the key to the success lies in proper implementation without any exclusion and inclusion errors. Implementation of ICT tools, information communication technology tools, and new initiatives like big data and blockchain will be an answer to the transparency and proper governance of this scheme. Thank you.